HHNA working as a biology CRT in KGPV Raspalem, Guntur district. Children, I am going to ask one question. If I give you an assignment to draw a cell, if it is animal cell or plant cell, so how can you draw that cell? So you can start with the boundary of this cell. Yes? So like this way. So first of all, you can draw like this way, the boundary of this cell. Then we will draw the nucleus, mitochondria, Golgi complex, etc. So cytoplasm, etc. So the outer membrane of this cell is called cell membrane. So this is the cell membrane. So in previous classes, we already learned about the cell is the basic structure of life and cell the structure and functions of the life. In that videos, we have already learned about the cell membrane. So it gives the protection to the entire cell organelles. Cell membrane, as we know that, is also called plasma membrane. So it is also called plasma membrane. So children, today we are going to learn about the plasma membrane in 9th class biology textbook, the 4th lesson. So I am going to write the topic. So you can write in your notebooks, children. So today our topic is plasma membrane.
Children, in this video we are going to know about plasma membrane in detailed manner. So children, tell me what exactly this is. I am sure your answer will be it is a cell. Now to study this, we'll need to know every component within, and not only within, we even need to study the covering, that is this part, in detail. Now can you tell me what exactly is this named as? That's right. The covering membrane of the cell is called as cell membrane or plasma membrane. It is selectively permeable in nature. That is, it only allows specific materials to enter or leave a cell. Any guesses what is the plasma membrane is made up of? It is made up of lipids and proteins and also has some carbohydrate chains. There are two things that they are freely moves in and out to the cell. Those include gases and water. It is very interesting to know how substances pass through cell. To understand the entry or exit of substances through the cell, let us do the following activities. For doing these activities, we have to prepare different solutions.
Children, to prepare salt or sugar solution, we need salt or sugar, 1 beaker and water and 1 spatula or spoon. Now I am going to prepare sugar solution. First, take 1 beaker, fill it with water. Then I am taking sugar with a spoon, add to the water. Thank you.
So children, in this the water is called as solvent and the sugar is called as solute. So these both are mixed and forming the sugar solution. So I am going to stir it well. When the sugar dissolves in water completely, the sugar solution is ready. So children, understand how to make sugar solution? Good. Now children, I am going to prepare a saturated solution. For this, we need 1 beaker water and sugar or salt, spatula or spoon, whatever. So first of all, I am taking 1 beaker and fill it with water, approximately 100 ml of water. For this, I am using measuring jar. So measuring jar is filled with water, exactly 100 ml of water. Yes, so poured into the beaker. Then I am going to prepare salt saturated solution. That's why I take salt and add it into the beaker. So children, add more and more salt to the beaker, because the salt completely dissolved in the water. Stir it well. Yes. Again, add some amount of salt to the solution if necessary. So stir it well again. Repeat it till little amount of it is left at the bottom of the beaker, which will not dissolve. So this is the saturated solution of salt. For this we can use cold water. Children, now I am going to do our activity to identifying the concentrated solution. For this we need 3 beakers, 1 measuring jar, sugar, 1 spatula and water. So these are the required material for doing this activity. Now I am going to demonstrate the activity. So first of all, we take 3 beakers and mark it as 1, marking 1, 2 and 3. Now fill with 100 ml of water in each. So for this I am using measuring jar. So children, carefully observe. I am taking 100 ml of water and fill with these 3 jars. Like this way. Again. So okay children, fill with 100 ml of water in each beaker. Now add 1/2 teaspoon full of sugar to the first beaker. And 1 teaspoon full of to the second one. and 1.5 teaspoon full to the third one. So in first beaker we add 1/2 spoon of sugar, and second beaker 1/2 spoon of sugar, and in third beaker we added 1.5 spoon of sugar. Okay children, now mix it thoroughly like this way. So now compare these three solutions, children. So children, tell me which beaker will be most sugary? Yes, that's right. The third beaker has to be most sugary. What is the reason, children? Yes, the reason is amount of sugar present in the 100 ml of water is the high. When compared with the beaker 1 and beaker 2. Okay children, so in beaker 3 sugar is the high. This is called as the concentration of the sugar. So the third beaker has the most concentrated solution as well as first and second. Based on the concentration, the solutions are of three types. They are hypertonic solution, isotonic solution, and hypotonic solution. So the coming video explains the nature of the solutions. Take 3 plates or containers with salt solutions in different concentrations in each. Let us add a few blood cells, that is RBCs, in each. After we noticed that the first set has the cells which are shrinked, the second set has the cells that just are same, while the third set has the cells are swollen or bulged. Children, any idea why this happened? Let us understand this. In the first case, the water content in the surrounding solution was less as compared to the cells placed in it. In other words, the salt content of the solution is more, and therefore this solution is a concentrated one. That is the reason the water molecules moved from inside the cells to the outside solution. Hence, the cells are shrinking. This type of solution is called as hypertonic solution. That is the solution with the higher salt concentration. Now let's have a look at the second case. Here the level of salt and water seems to be the same on either side of the cell membranes, that is both within and outside of the cell. Therefore there was the balance in the movement of water. Children, what we were understand by this? It means that the movement of water was the same in either directions. As a result, the size of the cell change remains or same. Students, do you know what such a solution is called? It is called as isotonic solution. The two solutions are isotonic when the concentration of water is same on either sides of the semi-permeable membrane. Now let us focus on the third set. The cells in this case are surrounded by a dilute solution, that is by higher water concentration. The salt dissolved is less and the water content is higher. Therefore the water molecules move inside the cells and hence the cells get swollen. Such a solution is called as hypotonic solution. In other words, a solution with a higher water concentration compared to the other. This is how various solutions and the different concentrations help cells to sustain the pressure and survive. Understand, children? So children, for doing this activity, the materials required are 2 resins. So it is also called dry kismis, and 100 ml of water. Take out into the bowl, and salt. So these are the required materials. Now coming to the procedure, take 100 ml of water into a beaker and keep dry raisins in it. So leave for one day. After one day, what has happened, children? Yes, the raisins are swollen. So at the beginning and at the ending of this activity, we observed the changes occurred. Now coming to the step 2. So take out the kismis from the bowl. Now add salt in a beaker to make saturated solution. So mix it thoroughly. Yes. Now keep swollen kismis of the previous activity, or we will take fresh grape also, no problem. So leave it overnight and observe in the next morning what happens. Do you find any change in the size of the kismis? Yes, it is shrinked. So children, in first procedure the kismis swollen, and in the second procedure kismis shrinked. So children, let us think the answers to the following questions. How water goes in and comes out of kismis? Does the layer permits water to pass through? And how does it works? So I'm going to explain. The cells in the outer layer of kismis permit water to pass through. This process is called osmosis. In this activity, what we have observed? Water from the surrounding medium enters the cells of raisins, helping them to swell. Now, coming to know about the definition of osmosis. Osmosis is a process in which water moves from higher water concentration to lower water concentration through a semi-permeable membrane. Osmosis is a Greek word. In Greek, osmosis means pushing. Now I am going to demonstrate of osmosis with a potato cup. So before going to do an activity, I recollect the definition of osmosis again. The movement of water molecules from low concentration point to high concentration point through a semi-permeable membrane is called osmosis. This transportation does not require energy. For this activity, some materials are required. They are potato, sugar, knife, spoon, dropper, bell pin, petri dish and water. Now coming to do an activity. First take raw potato and cut it into cube shape like this way. So carefully cut it. Now make it as a cup shape. For this we used this type of things. It is a easy way to make a cup. So with the help of spoon, make a potato cup from it like this way. So students, observe carefully. Yes, now our potato cup is ready. Now take a beaker or glass and add 100 ml of water and sugar also. So now prepare a few amount of saturated sugar solution, that means high concentrated solution. So already we prepared in previous activities. Yes, children? Yes. So in the same way here we are preparing high concentrated solution. Now keep the potato cup in a petri dish or bowl and fill it with the sugar solution. Just half of the potato cup. So fill with the sugar solution and mark the level of by piercing a pin. So bell pin we can use to mark. Then pour water in the petri dish. Slowly pour the water into the petri dish. And observe the water levels in both potato cup and petri dish and leave it for 1 hour. So children, what we are observed in this petri dish and potato cup? Yes, the water level increased in potato cup and decreased in petri dish. Am I right, children? Yes. So here we can observe clearly before and after activity. The water level increased in potato cup while decreased in petri dish. This indicates water molecules enter into potato cup from petri dish. Now repeat the above experiment by taking sugar solution in petri dish and water in the potato cup. So the normal water in potato cup and the sugar solution in petri dish we added. Mark with the bell pin. Now observe the water levels in both potato cup and petri dish and leave it for 1 hour. So children, what you are observing here? Yes. So the water level decreased in potato cup and increased in petri dish. So here we can see the difference between before and after complete the activity. The water level decreased in potato cup while increased in petri dish. This indicates water molecules enter into petri dish from potato cup. So in these two situations, water molecules move from low concentration point to high concentration point through a semi-permeable membrane without using any energy. So this is called osmosis. The membrane that allows water is called permeable membrane. To understand how materials may be moving in and out of cells through the cell membrane, let us do the following activity. To perform this activity, we need the following materials. Now coming to the procedure. So we already prepared a wheat flour solution and take one filter paper. So fold like this way and put it into the funnel. So now already made solution, that is wheat flour solution, poured into the filter paper which is insert in the funnel and leave it for some time. So children, what we observed? Yes, the water coming from the funnel. Yes children? Yes. So after some time we observed the water completely drain out and the precipitate left in the funnel. Now coming to the know about the definition of the filtration. Filtration is the process by which insoluble solids can be removed from a liquid by using a filter paper or a membrane. In the filtration process, liquid that filters through is the filtrate, undissolved solid particles or residue. Children, tell me which substance is not allowed by the filter paper and why? Guess children. cells also act in the same way while allowing the substances to pass through the membrane is called plasma membrane. Let us try to understanding the nature of plasma membrane. Children, you already learned about animal cell. Now let us do another activity to understand the movement of water in animals. For this, we required the materials or HCl, two beakers, cloth, two raw eggs, one spoon, a strip of paper and salt. Now coming to the procedure. Take two beakers and prepare dilute hydrochloric acid in both, like this way. So, adding dilute HCl with the help of dropper into the beakers. So, both beakers. Okay, children. Now, keep two raw eggs in dilute HCl for 4 to 5 hours. Drop slowly, children. Yes. So leave it for 4 to 5 hours. Observe, children. So what is going on here? Yes, some bubbles are coming from the eggshell. So, eggshell made up of calcium carbonate. It reacts with acid to form calcium chloride and gives out carbon dioxide gas. That's why we observed these bubbles. Okay, children, observe keenly. Now leave it for 5 hours. After that, take out the eggs by using a spoon carefully. So like this way, and put it into the water slowly. Wash the eggs in tap water and wipe them by using a cloth. Children, so carefully clean the eggs. Why? Because the outer layer, that is the shell, dissolved in the HCl. So cleaning is over. Now measure the circumference of each egg with a long strip of paper and mark on the paper with a pen. Now coming to the another egg. So this egg also measured and marked with the pen. Now take two beakers and prepare concentrated salt solution in one beaker and take fresh water in another beaker. Stir it well. This is the concentrated salt solution, that is hypertonic, and the another beaker having fresh water, that is the hypotonic solution. Now place one egg in the salt water slowly while another egg in fresh water, that is tap water. Slowly drop it. So leave it for 5 hours. After 5 hours, what's happening here, children? So the egg placed in salt water shrinks. The egg placed in tap water swells. Do you observe, children? So take out the eggs from beakers and measure their circumferences with the same strip of paper. So with the help of a strip, the first egg measured. So what we observed here? Yes, the measuring is decreased. That means the size of the egg placed in salt water decreased. So in the same way, the measuring of another egg with the help of a strip paper, the size of the egg placed in tap water increased. So understand, children? If you understand, tell me why the egg shrinks and swells. Yes, that's right. This is due to osmosis. In the first beaker, salt water is more concentrated than the albumin present in the egg. These two solutions are separated by egg membrane. Already we know that egg membrane acts as a semi-permeable membrane. Hence, water molecules moved from low concentration point, that is albumin, to high concentration point, that is salt water, so that the egg present in the salt water is shrinks. While in the second beaker, albumin present in the egg is more concentrated than the fresh water. Hence, water molecules moves from fresh water to albumin, so that the egg present in the fresh water swells. In the first situation, water molecules leave the cell. This process is called exosmosis. In the second situation, the water molecules enter into the cell. This process is called endosmosis. In plants, osmosis plays a major role in absorption of water by root hair. Root hairs are surrounded by the moisture. Soil water is more dilute than the plasma of the cells of root hairs. Cell membrane acts as semi-permeable membrane. Due to osmosis, water moves from soil to cells of the root hair. The aim of this activity to prepare semi-permeable membrane by using egg membrane. To perform this activity, following materials are required. There are 3 beakers, 2 egg membranes, sugar, water, thread, measuring jar, disposable syringe, cloth and tablespoon. Now coming to the procedure. Take the eggs that are soaked in the dilute HCl solution and wash the eggs under tap water and wipe them with cloth. Now remove the internal content present in the egg membranes carefully by making a pencil-sized hole in them. Then take out these 2 egg membranes and wash the membranes with fresh water, like this way. So both egg membranes cleaned up. Now take 1 egg membrane and fill it with 10 ml of saturated sugar solution by using syringe. Next, tie the mouth of the membrane with the help of a thread. Now take a beaker containing 100 ml of tap water and dip the membrane into it. Now leave it aside for one night. Now coming to the next step. So take the second membrane and fill it with 10 ml of tap water with the help of syringe and tie its mouth with the help of thread. Take another beaker containing 100 ml of saturated sugar solution and place the second membrane inside this beaker like this way. So measure the contents of the egg membranes and beakers and note down the observations. Now coming to the observations. It is observed that in case of beaker 1, the water level in beaker is decreased and the sugar solution present inside the egg membrane is increased. In case of beaker 2, the sugar solution present inside the beaker is increased and the tap water present inside the egg membrane is decreased. From this experiment, we learn that the level of solution of egg membrane or beaker is increasing only when they have the sugar solution in them. The sugar molecules are too large to pass through the membrane, hence the water molecules pass into the sugar solution. This decreases the level of water and increases the level of sugar solution. This increase of sugar solution is due to osmosis across the semi-permeable membrane. Semi-permeable membrane allows only certain materials to pass through the cells. Now come to know about another transport process, that is diffusion.
Children, in our day-to-day life, we can smell so many substances like scent smell, flowers, powder smell, like that way. So these smells spread entirely in our room uniformly. So when we walk beside the drainage, we can smell that drainage stagnant smell. How we can smell these substances? So the substances which are spread uniformly with the help of medium like air, water, etc. So that materials uniformly spread out the mediums, using of mediums. So that is called diffusion. So going to write the definition of
crystals taking into the petri dish. Now I am using dropper with the help of dropper. So I add some water to the potassium permanganate crystals. So children, you can observe keenly what changes happens in this petri dish. Students getting clumsy? Okay. So for better understanding, I am going to repeat this activity in another way. For this, I am going to take watch glass again.
Add some water to it. Then take potassium permanganate crystals.
Again.
So using with the spatula. Little amount of potassium permanganate crystals or
added to the water.
So you can observe it is spreading in the water. Here the process, that is diffusion process, occurred. Understand children? Good. So children, I am doing another experiment, is another example. For this we required one beaker, spatula, water and copper sulfate crystals. Okay children? Okay. Now fill the beaker with water. Then adding copper sulfate crystals. Copper sulfate crystals. In blue color, using spatula I am adding some of copper sulfate crystals to the water. So what happened children, observe. So the water turned into bluish color. So the copper sulfate crystals dissolve in water and the water turned into bluish color. So here also we can observe the water is medium and the crystals are the substance. So substance with the help of medium, the process is called diffusion. Here the medium is water. Okay, understand children? So this is the another example for the diffusion.
So children, last but not the least, I am going to repeat what we have learned in this video. The cell is surrounded by a cell membrane. It is also called as the plasma membrane. The cell membrane protects the cell from the outer environment. The cell membrane gives structure to the cell. It also separates the components of the cell from the outer environment. It is a selectively permeable membrane and only allows a few specific substances to pass through it. It is also a semi-permeable membrane and only allows small substances and solvents like water to pass through it.
Children, just wait. So are you following the precautions to overcome the COVID-19 disease? Yes. So the third wave is coming and of course schools are also reopened. So you must take care about your health and take precautions to overcome this COVID pandemic situation. So be careful and be safe, be healthy, be happy. So children, how do you feel to watching this video? Is it good? Okay. So if you have any doubts, please go back and repeat the video. Get clarification. And my special thanks to Samagra Shiksha Andhra Pradesh for giving me this opportunity. It's a beautiful opportunity to me. So thank you.